some places on the surface, you might have these steep cracks and giant fissures that you would have to be careful not to fall into. In other places, you might see towers of ice right next to places that were relatively smooth. You might see places that were dark. Ice there takes the form of rock. It's frozen solid until you dig down into that ocean. So you may see some things that look similar to Earth, but you may see some things that are very different.
That voice you just heard?
I am Morgan Cable, NASA scientist.
I love it.
That's Morgan. She's probably one of NASA's best spokespeople for exploring our solar system's icy moons.
Europa's a fascinating place. It has this liquid water ocean that's about 3 times the volume of all of Earth's oceans combined. That's a lot of water.
To understand what makes Earth so special, sometimes you need to back up and take in the big picture. Remember, the cryosphere is every place on Earth with frozen water. And water is one of the biggest indicators for life.
Every place, at least so far, that we have found life, we found water along with it.
And so far, Earth is the only planet we know of with life. Although Europa isn't the only icy moon in our solar system, NASA has identified it as one of those places with key astrobiological potential. Morgan is a collaborator on the Mapping Imaging Spectrometer for Europa, an instrument selected for NASA's next mission to Jupiter's icy moon Europa. But she's also more than just a scientist working in a laboratory. She's preparing future NASA missions for success on the surface of alien worlds. This year, Morgan and her colleagues were in the field studying how life colonizes in fresh lava.
Earth, it turns out, has a lot of excellent, what we call analog environments, places that are similar enough to some of these other worlds that we can conduct some tests and we can do some analyses here. Now, they're not perfect, of course. They're not going to be exactly like Europa, but we can still learn a lot by testing in these environments. Some of these places include Antarctica and the Arctic Circle, but there are other places too, Alaska, Greenland, even Iceland. Any place where you have a lot of ice, because guess what the surface of Europa is made of? A lot of ice.
Studying the cryosphere doesn't just have big implications for Earth. It also matters for the frozen worlds in our own cosmic backyard.
If we're able to find life or evidence of past life on a place like Europa, that tells us that not only can life happen in other places, but it's common enough that it happened at least twice in the same tiny solar system. That means that the universe is wide open in terms of how much life we might find, the types of life we might find. It would revolutionize how we see ourselves and the possibilities for contact in the universe. It would be amazing. Oh, it's so exciting.
As it flows down the valleys, it actually carves those valleys out and it makes them deeper. And so it creates these beautiful fjords where the ice flows down, snakes out down to the ocean or to the lakes or further inland. And so that ice is flowing, it's moving.